Hello, in this video, I'm going to show you how to build drop-down lists with HTML forms. So we'll cover the following topics. First off, we'll see drop-down list in action, and then I'll show you the HTML code to build a drop-down list, and finally, we'll pull it all together with a full JSP page example. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. So first off, here's a drop-down list in action. We have a student and they can select their country. And so we can give them all the different options of the countries here. And so this is an example of a drop-down list. And I'll show you the HTML code on how to build this type of drop-down list. Okay, so let's look at the HTML code for building a drop-down list. So basically you make use of a select tag. So here we have select and we say name equals country. And then you drop in all the different options that you'll have here for the drop-down list. So here we have option Brazil, France, Germany, India, and so on. And this will actually help us build the drop-down list for our application. And note here where we have the select name equals country. Country, that's the name of the form field you use in your JSP page to read the form data, and I'll show you that later in the demo. All right, so let's pull it all together. So we're going to have an HTML form that's going to request the student's name, first, last, and also their country. They're going to submit their form data, and then we're going to have a JSP page that'll actually process this and will display the student's name and also display the user's selected country. So I always like to have a to-do list. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create an HTML form. And then the second thing we'll do is build the JSP confirmation page. All right, let's move into Eclipse and try this out. All right, so we're in Eclipse. What I'd like to do is to continue to use the existing project, JSP demo. And what we're going to do is we're actually going to have a form. So the form is going to be very similar to the previous one. So I simply want to copy our previous form and use that as a starting point. So select studentform.html, just do a right click and choose copy. And then right click and choose paste. We simply want to paste a copy of this. So just do a paste. And at this point, Eclipse will prompt you for a new name for the form. So the name we're going to use here is studentdropdownform.html. So studentdropdownform.html, that's the new name of our form. And once you're happy with the name, go ahead and click OK. Okay, great. So now we should have this new form here, studentdropdownform.html. Let's go ahead and open this form up and take a look at it. And I'll expand the window here for a second. Okay, great. So the first thing we want to do is on line 7, we want to change the actual JSP page is going to point to. So we want it to point to studentdropdownresponse.jsp. Again, studentdropdownresponse.jsp. That's the new page that we're going to create in this video for actually processing the form data from the dropdown list. Now everything else here is the same. Let's move down to line 16. And let's let's just do some white space here. And let's add in the actual tag for that drop-down list using the select tag. So I'll say select name equals country. And now here I'll go through and I'll add the different options for the countries. So I'll start off with the first country here, Brazil. France. Germany. And just more of the same. I'll just repeat this for all the other countries here. I'll speed the video up just to list out all the other countries here. Okay, great. So these are all the countries, and this is our drop-down list. So this is great. This is kind of what we wanted to do for building the HTML drop-down list. Good job so far. All right, so now let's go ahead and work on our JSP page. Again, our JSP page is going to be very similar to our previous page we created, so we're simply going to copy it. So choose studentresponse.jsp, right-click, and choose copy. And then do another right-click and choose paste. And we'll give a new name for it here, so we'll call it studentdropdownresponse.jsp. studentdropdownresponse.jsp. We'll hit OK. And now we have this new page that was just created, studentdropdownresponse.jsp. Let's go ahead and double-click this file and open it. All right, so this had the very basic page confirmation from the previous video. And now what we're going to do is just add information about reading from that drop-down list, with the name of country. So here I say the student's country, and I'll use that $curly brace param.country, and that'll read the information from that drop-down list. So good job. All right, so let's go ahead and try this out. So to test it, we'll select our form, student drop-down form.html. We'll do a right click and we'll choose run as, run on server. And this will bring up the form and we can enter the user's first name and last name, AJ, Rao, and we'll choose his country of India. And once we're happy with everything, we'll hit the submit button. Okay, great. So we have the student's name. And also note here the student's country, and that's all based on us reading that drop-down list from the JSP page. So good job, we were successful with that. All right, well this wraps up the video. In this video I showed you how to build drop-down list with HTML forms, and also how to read that form data with JSP. Great job.